The B final, the men's 1500 meter to be contested at Palo Velo. Normally this wouldn't be a race of all that much significance. There is significance right here because we're looking at the ice and we don't see Apollo Antonono. There are six skaters scheduled, only five are on the ice, and we have no idea where Ono is right now. Apparently neither does Yuki.
The first thing that comes to mind to me is that maybe Apollo got injured in the last race or decided, well, we see Lee here. It looks like she's a little confused.
This is the new United States short track coach, a former pioneer in this sport, skating for China in the late 80s and early 90s. Obviously, Lee is talking about something with the officials.
This is beautiful.
Well, there's clearly confusion, and what a bizarre moment this is. Well, there it is, Apollo Antonono trying to come out on the ice, apparently to skate in this B final. It frankly is a race that means almost nothing. And for a moment there, it was bizarre because the skaters came on the ice, and you could see even the skaters themselves, they were looking back in the tunnels and saying, isn't Apollo going to join us? Where is he? Well, here he comes.
This race doesn't mean a whole lot to Apollo. He's not in the A final. He's not going to win a medal. But this can't be great for his mental state going into the race.
I mean, it's unbelievable. They're introducing the other skaters, and now look at some of the officials are trying to keep Apollo from going out.
Maybe they don't know who he is.
Then they need a crash course. And look at Apollo. He just takes matters in his own hands. And listen to the crowd react to this.
Now, position number five, representing the United States, Apollo Antonono.
Hey, this is bizarre. But why not? It's short track.
Starting position number six, representing
the only reason a B final has ever skated in this sport. And there's Fabio Carta getting one more skate tonight in his hometown. B finals are skated only in case of a massive disqualification in the A final that might leave there to be a shortcoming of medalists, but that's very unlikely in the 1500 meter.
Four skaters would need to be disqualified in the A final for the winner of the B final to get a bronze medal.
But we'll see how Apollo, with this very late arrival on ice, and what his mindset is like after the disappointment in the semis. Now, Dan, you skated, you're a teammate of Apollo's, you were a roommate of Apollo's for a while. Take a guess right now. Your best guess as to his mindset.
I think Paul is a little confused right now. He's playing this race from the back. I think he's probably trying to collect his thoughts. Take a moment to relax, take some deep breaths. No matter what, his heart is pumping right now.
And going out and just calmly cruising in the back of the pack of this 13-and-a-half lap race.
Normally, this race would be pretty easy for Apollo. His only real competition would be Turcotte, who's now in front. Apollo's heart is pumping. He has to stay collected and collect his thoughts.
And of course, as this race goes along, the longer Fabio Carta stays near the front, the more excited this Palo Velo audience will be.
Apollo's still probably pretty confused. I haven't missed a race or been late to the race since I was about 12 years old. And Apollo did this in the Olympics. He's got to be confused.
I think it confused everybody. Spectators, coaches, and fellow skaters. What impresses everyone who has a chance to meet Apollo or listen to him, as much of the world's press did in the press conference this past week, is how mature he is, how maturity beyond his years, and the strength of that mind is being tested right now, being tested by what he endured, being really taking himself out of the semifinals.
This is a difficult race for Apollo to be competing in. He'll still be there at the end, but his focus was really on the A final.
Fabio Carta getting the crowd excited as he takes the lead. Turcotte moving up on the outside from Canada. And Apollo still hanging back. Now Ono makes a move past one. to go. Apollo should really move up if his goal is to win this race, but he just doesn't look like he's into this race.
Really no gain in terms of any possible medal contention here.
Well, here he goes building up some speed. He is going to try an outside pass.
Lap and a half. The same outside pass that cost him trouble in the 1500. Looks like may get him to the front.
Look at this amazing attempt by Ono. He's got a chance here as they come around the last turn, but he got pushed a little bit wide by Carta, and Ono will cross third. Turcotte and Carta 1-2.
Paul didn't have his mind into that race. It wasn't a smart race. He was thinking about the semifinal where he got knocked out.
And for all the world, it looked like he wasn't going to skate it at all until he came running literally on his skate guards, running down the hallway at the very last moment.
This point, Apollo has to get off the ice, do a nice cool down, and think about his next race.
And Apollo will next. It's a very light week. The men will participate in the 1,000-meter heats only on Wednesday. There will be no men's medals awarded until next Saturday. So it is actually a lot of time to think.
It is a lot of time, and the 1,000 is Apollo's best race, in my opinion.
Shades of Munich 1972 and the two American sprinters who were given the wrong schedule for their qualifying heat in the 100-meter run. The difference, of course, was that that was competitively meaningful. This, at the end of the day, was not. But it's a disappointing start to the 2006 games for Apollo Anton Ono. He will take the ice again on Wednesday in the 1,000 meters and the 5,000-meter relay. And when we return, we'll head back to the Palavela for the women's relay.